Hey guys, thanks for all the support on my show reel. You guys asked for the Ironman tutorial, so here it is. Although I won't cover 3D modeling, since there are many tutorials available for it, we will recreate this scene and this time it will look like this. The original version was longer because I had stretched the video quite a lot so that you can properly see what's going on, and there's so much detailing in it that I wanted it to last longer. Not gonna do that this time, I don't want to render that much again. So let's begin. For this series we need Photoshop. You can use any image editing software. Then After Effects, any CC version, plus we need two additional plugins, Optical Fails and Trapcode Particular. These two are optional, although I do recommend getting these if you don't have them already. We'll talk about them while compositing. And last we need 3ds Max. You can get a 3-year long student license for free, and don't worry, there are no limitations in it. You can render any size images and you won't get any watermarks or anything. You can also use Maya if you want, since the camera tracking which we'll do in After Effects can also be exported to Maya. I will stick with Max, and for renderer, the original version was rendered in V-Ray, but this time I will use Arnold renderer because it's commonly used in VFX industry, but mostly because it recently got integrated in Max, which means it's not third party anymore, we don't have to download it separately. And it also means that it's free, so no contest in that, right? If you have a basic knowledge of these two softwares, then this tutorial will be a piece of cake to you. But if you don't know these softwares, then just try to follow along. You know, there are people who give up, quit, move on.
What about us?
Before you shoot, you need to keep these three things in mind. I didn't do any of these because I was still learning back then. I didn't know. Anyways, you guys should do it. It will save you a lot of your time. First thing to keep in mind, the actor should wear skinny fit clothes. That's because the suit is skinny fit, right? So if you like have a sleeve hanging around and then you add the 3D suit on top of it, then you will get this. So wear skinny fit, just like in all Iron Man suit up scenes. Even in Infinity War, I was like, how is he gonna? And then he was like, shh. And then I was like, anyways, I'll show you later how to fix this mistake. Second thing to keep in mind, get photos of the actor in the very same pose. Like, do it just after shooting. Keep your actor frozen and get the front view, side view, back, top if you can. Just like when you do car modeling or something, you get photos from all different views like that only. Last, you need to install Google Street View app in your phone. Use this app to get a 360 degree photo of the location you are shooting. You can use this photo for lighting and getting accurate reflections on your 3D model. And exclude your actor from this photo because we don't want their reflection on the model. It's okay if the image is not accurate. Even if it has tearing, we can still use it. There are a few more things you need to keep in mind. We will talk about them while tracking. So what camera tracking does is, it scans your video and extracts the camera movement as well as the position of everything you shot. We will use that data to add 3D stuff in our scene. Let's start After Effects. I'm gonna drag this video in the project panel, then drag it to this icon to create a new composition. We don't need audio, so mute it. Hit spacebar to preview. The video was shot in 1080p, 25fps, and since we dragged the video in create new comp icon, this same settings will be applied to our composition. By the way, this is my friend Manish. I'll link his Instagram, make sure you guys follow him. In After Effects, we can only track still scene, So we need to trim the video where our actor goes completely still. I will show how to track a moving character in the next Iron Man series. It will only have tracking, rigging and nano setup. And if something new comes up in endgame, then I'll include that. So let's trim from here. He goes still. Yeah, from here. So press Alt plus open square bracket to trim, or you can just click and drag and then shift to snap it. Then right click on the layer and pre-compose, move all attributes, and let's rename this to iron. Okay, now double click to go inside. Okay, so now everything is frozen, only the camera is moving. This is important in After Effects. If you want accurate tracking, then everything should be frozen. I'll save the file before tracking. So to start tracking, select the layer, then click on this track camera button. If this tracker panel is missing, then go to Window and turn it on over here. As you can see, it's analyzing. Here we don't have any option to isolate a specific area. So you can't use masks or anything to tell After Effects which area to track and which one to ignore. So avoid any movement. You can have some, like the leaves swaying or something, but you can't have a vehicle pass by. It will make your tracking inaccurate. This tracker doesn't have much features, but it's the easiest one to use and it's significantly faster than all other trackers out there. So the tracking is done. Let's see. Now first select the effect. Okay, we got these track points. Now check if they stick properly on the surface. They need sharp pixels to grab onto. So if I had defocused the background, then the points in the back would have just slid around everywhere. That brings us to our next requirement. No defocus at all. So use a lens which has infinite focus. If your lens doesn't have that, then just watch a tutorial on how to get infinite focus. I won't get into that. Also no motion blur. That's also for same reason. So either keep higher FPS or move your camera slowly. You can add motion blur with just one click, so don't bother adding it while shooting. And last thing to keep in mind, the ground should be visible. Without it, the tracker just can't figure out depth and the tracking is all weird. If you don't want ground in your scene, then there's a different type of tracking we can do. I'll include that in the next series. It will even work if your background is defocused. Okay, moving on. When you hover between any three track points, this ring appears. It's basically aligned to those three points. Here the ring should look like it's placed on the surface of the ground. If it doesn't, like this one, then that means one or more of these points are not on the surface. Might be underground or floating above. We can't use these points. Let's find something useful. This one looks good. Left click to select these three points. Then right click and create solid and camera. Okay, so we got our camera now. Now let's see. Let's check the custom view. Here we can see the camera has some animation and it's moving exactly like I moved the real camera while shooting. It was handled okay, don't judge me. Let's go back and check if the camera is actually working properly. Let me just rename this. It's on the ground, so okay. So select the tracking. Select any point and right click, create null. And just check if it sticks properly. Okay, this seems to stick. That means our camera is working properly. Again, rename this thing. Okay. Now we need to export this tracking data to 3ds Max. Although there is a limitation, we can only export these layers but not the effect. And since all the track points are inside this effect, they won't show up in Max. You will have to manually create a few track points, just like we created this wrist layer. Same step, select the point, right click, create null, and rename it. Don't forget to rename these, it will be very useful in Max. Now repeat this step until you get like 8 or 10 track points. Double check if it sticks properly. We don't want floating track points. I have created 9 track points which are all located on the actor. If you want to add 3D stuff in the background, then create track point close to where you wanna add. This is good to go. So lesson 1 is complete. In the next lesson, we will export this data to Max and create the base model.